First hadith 69 عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قيل يا رسول الله من أكرم الناس who is the most generous people. أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه he said قيل somebody asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم it was said to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم who is the most generous among people من أكرم الناس قال أتقاه the one who has taqwa in his heart. You know the funny thing is you cannot translate this word. Taqwa comes from prevention. تتقي شيء is to have to use to practice prevention. So how you can relate this to in Islam? So in Islam this is one of the words that took totally different meaning in Islam than before Islam. So the word Arab the Arabic word of taqwa did exist before Islam. But the minute Islam came, the word taqwa had totally elevated itself with complex meaning of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you say اتق النار اتق الحر you have to wear your clothes to prevent heat, you have to wear your clothes to prevent cold, you have to watch out for sickness, so prevent your sickness by taking chicken soup, whatever it is, those are all prevention, you know, like we practice, our mothers also did lots of preventions for us and the kind of food that she will give us and stuff like this. This was all called taqwa. And wiqaya, we relate to this as wiqaya khayr min al-ilaj, right? We used to have that famous adage like prevention is better than treatment, right? Like prevention, and I think it is said here in a different way. It says a bound of prevention is better than 1,000 bound of treatment or something like this, or a million pound of treatment or something. So there was another, I don't remember exactly how it is said, but something to that effect, that it is what you spend in prevention is much better than after you get sick and you treat. So it is better to wash your hands than getting sick and spending so much money in treatment. It is better to wear proper clothes so that you don't go in the cold and catch cold, and then you sleep and you cannot even do because you're in a hurry and you think you're gonna go, but then you can stay for 10 days at home because you're in a hurry one day for 5 minutes. To save 5 minutes, you lose 10 days. So a bound of prevention is million times better than all the money you're gonna spend in treatment later on, so or what you're gonna waste in treatment. That meaning that is also there, because that's prevention to be punished, prevention the punishment of to see the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prevention of hellfire, prevention of the anger of Allah, prevention afraid that to damage the relationship between you and Allah, so that prevention of damage of the relationship. So all is about taqwa, prevention. But in reality it came with this, how you reach it? Through the obedience of Allah, right? Through the good a'mal, and through doing that which is good and forbidding that which is not doing that which is wrong. That's so that is the balance. So when you put all this together, became the word taqwa of its new meaning under Islam. So when you tell me translate it to English, I would just say prevention, but I don't know how that means. What is prevention means? I don't know what it is.
يتقي محارم الله.
يتقي محارم نعم. Yeah, متقي. But not only taqwa محارم الله. You have to also obey the orders of Allah, because there is maharam and there is orders. The orders are extras, and that's the taqwa. So the taqwa is not just at the level of maharam. There's the ordinary person can stop at what is wrong, what is haram, but the taqi person will continue to do as much as he can from what is halal, which is فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. In that sense, is to bring as much as you can from the ibadah, the nafl, the sadaqah, the zakat, whatever it is that you can add the most. Because of that, the word it has different dimensions than the linguistic dimension. So the sharia meaning of the word became much bigger than the linguistic meaning of the word. And that's why the translation, except if English speaking Muslims would use it of the same meaning of the word taqwa as well, when it is said it will carry the same meanings within Islam, but that did not happen yet. In order for us to use say prevention, so as prevention as taqwa, so it did not happen yet. قال أتقاهم فقالوا ليس عن هذا نسألك. We were not asking about this. No, that's not what you were asking. قال فيوسف نبي الله ابن نبي الله ابن نبي الله ابن خليل الله ابن خليل الله فيوسف نبي الله ابن نبي الله ابن نبي الله ابن خليل الله.
So
this is the proper way. قالوا ليس عن هذا نسألك يعني أكرم الناس. In this sense he sent the generous أكرم. The word أكرم الناس is not generous. The word كريم is generous. كريم is honorable, right? So when he asked about أكرم الناس, he meant the most honorable of people, not the most generous of people. It could have been. Now that I'm looking at the hadith, قال أتقاهم, the most honorable among people, إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. This is the ayah. This is from Quran directly. So the answer for Rasulullah directly. So the answer for Rasulullah directly from Quran. إن أكرمكم يا أيها الناس إن خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعرفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. إن سو أكرم الناس عند الله أتقاكم. طيب they said not, no, we're not asking about this. So he thought about the most honorable people in the sense of their family traits, lineage. So he started talking about Sayyidina Yusuf being a Nabi, the son of a Nabi, the son of a Nabi, the son of a Nabi. So he's that's the most honorable when you have a Nabi. His father is a Nabi, his grandfather is a Nabi, his great grandfather is a Nabi, his great great grandfather is a Nabi. I mean, there is nothing better than that. It's a family of Nabis. Subhanallah. And as prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قالوا ليس عن هذا نسألك. نسألك. They were not asking you about the lineage. You are not asking about that. قال فعن معادن العرب تسألوني. Are you asking me about the material of Arabs, the quality of Arab people? Is this what like being honorable, the Arabs or their tribes, or who are they? خيارهم في الجاهلية خيارهم في الإسلام إذا فقه. إذا فقه. If they understood the deen, they have the deep understanding of deen. إذا فقه. إذا فقه. إذا فقه. خيارهم في الجاهلية خيارهم في الإسلام. If it was معادن العرب, if it was that, so you said the best of them in جاهلية. If they become Muslims, those are also the best. So it is the makarim al-akhlaq and the best of manners. It is not within the deen, but the best of them, the deen elevates it right away. But they were so good that those who were the best among them in jahiliyyah, the minute they become Muslims, they would also be the best if they understood the deen. Not they go with the jahiliyyah or the asabiyyah or the wrong things of jahiliyyah, but if they understand the deen, then they will drop the wrong things and they will only follow that which is good.
Sorry, when they say the best of them in jahiliyyah, does that mean the people who were terrible or the people that were the good?
No, the people in jahiliyyah who were among them in the best, meaning preferred among them, like the head of tribes who were good, like the generous people, like the honorable people, and so on. If they come to Islam and understand Islam, they will continue to be generous, they will continue to be honorable, they will continue to be the best. So, which is quite interesting. You find people, really, when you look at them, you find people that they were so good in jahiliyyah, the minute they became Muslims, they became the leader right away. Well, Khalid ibn al-Walid was the top guy fighting Islam and became Umar Abul Khattab radiallahu anhu. He ate his god, you know, the god that he just, his father made the god from Ajwa, you know, from the AIDS. So he was hungry one day, he ate it. So I was very much worried because Al Khattab really beat him up for that. You know, how dare you eat my, he ate my god. It's funny. And so was Abu Bakr Siddiq. It's known to be a very honorable man who was always trading in a good way, respecting his trade, and was a very successful businessman. So Abdurrahman ibn Auf. And all of them are the names that we hear about, radiallahu anhu majma'in. So all those are the beautiful names that we always relate to when we relate stories of Rasulullah. Just give me a second.